talks. Yes, blood talks. In Genesis 4:10, we hear God asking Cain, "What have you done? The voice of your brother's innocent blood is crying out to me from the ground for justice." Cain had murdered his brother Abel in a fit of anger and jealousy. Blood talks. And not just with a spiritual voice. I've gone to labs and doctor's offices where they've taken a sample of my blood, and before you know it, they have this amazingly detailed report about my cholesterol, glucose levels, hormones, and a whole list of things. My blood is talking about my physical health. My friend Dr. Don Colbert reads my blood work like one would read a biography. He tells me things about myself I didn't know. Blood talks. Moses was telling the king of Egypt to free God's people, the Israelites, but Pharaoh stubbornly resisted. After many plagues brought much destruction on the land, one final plague was announced to come in Exodus 12. The oldest male would succumb to a deadly plague on this one night, both human and animal, if a sign of God's covenant was not placed over the doorpost of a home. The Israelites were instructed to take a little lamb, kill it, and apply its blood on the doorpost and beam above the door. This would speak for the family and tell death to pass over. That night, the plague of death came over Egypt and many, many died. From the firstborn of Pharaoh to people in the prison to even firstborn male cattle. The amazing thing was, not one firstborn son died in a house that had the marking of obedience where God instructed the lamb's blood to be applied over the door and the doorpost. The blood was speaking. Did you know that the famous Last Supper of Jesus in the upper room was a Passover celebration? Jesus and his disciples were remembering, as the Word of God instructed every Israelite, to have this special meal. It reminded every Jewish family that the blood was the sign of covenant with God and brought protection, provision, and peace. Was it a coincidence that on the night Jesus was betrayed, being led as the innocent lamb to the cross of Calvary, that it was Passover? You know it wasn't. It was God's plan from the beginning of time. Passover in Exodus 12 was but a foreshadowing of what was to come. Jesus' blood would be shed for all of humanity so that whoever would apply his precious DNA over the doorpost of their life would be saved from the plague. Did you hear that? The blood that marks a life as belonging to God and speaks of his covenant commands death to pass over. Hebrews 12:24 says that the blood of Jesus, the mediator of a better covenant, the best agreement between God and humanity, quote, speaks of mercy, a better and nobler and more gracious message than the blood of Abel, which cried out for vengeance, end quote. Praise God! You see, the devil is the accuser, and he likes to blame you and shame you before God. He's always trying to say why you deserve the plague of death. But Jesus' blood is speaking too. Jesus' blood cries mercy on your behalf. The thing is, you still have to apply the blood that never fails to your life. Quote, for with the heart a person believes in Christ as Savior, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation, end quote. That's Romans 10:10. Your words are evidence of your faith. Even society regards your words as evidence. You can apply the blood of Jesus to your life and home right now. It requires faith and your acknowledgement. Jesus' blood is talking, but only you can delegate the authority over your life and home to Jesus. Remember, God told the Israelites how to get the sign of the covenant on their life, but they had to apply it, accept it. God so loved you that he gave his only begotten Son with perfect blood. Now you must receive him and apply his blood. Let's pray the word. I declare in the name of Jesus that no plague will come near you or your dwelling place, according to Psalm 91:10. Jesus' blood is speaking on your behalf and crying for mercy, love, protection, help, and blessing. Receive the benefits of Jesus' shed blood for you and your family at the cross. May your life be marked with the sign of God's covenant by the blood of the Lamb, and in the name of Jesus, amen. Listen, if you've just prayed that prayer along with me and invited Jesus into your heart as your Lord and Savior, we want to help you. We want to give a gift of a Bible just for you. Please reach out on our website at allnationschurch.ca by email or phone. This is Pastor Stephen saying, we want you to know that God loves you. At All Nations Church, you are so important, and that we love you.